classic. Today let us start the chapter physical quantities and measurement. So first we will learn in this chapter what is density. Density of a substance is defined as mass per unit volume. So if we divide an object's mass by its volume, what we will get? We will get density. Density is written as rho. This sign is called rho. Density is equal to mass by volume. Its SI unit is kg per meter cube, because SI unit of mass is kg and SI unit of volume is meter cube. So kg per meter cube. And CDS unit is gram per centimeter cube. CDS unit of mass is gram and CDS unit of volume is centimeter cube. So CDS unit of density is gram per centimeter cube. This relation is very important. 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kg per meter cube. So if we want to convert from CDS unit to SI unit, we have to multiply it by 1000. So 2 gram per centimeter cube means 2000 kg per meter cube. See, here is an example given. See this box and this is a box. In this box what is there? Bottle. And in this box this is iron. Both of them mass is same. This is also 500 gram, this is also 500 gram. But as you can see, the molecules are very far apart. So obviously the density is very low. So as the density is very low and the mass is same, so obviously the volume will be high. So that's why this box is quite big. Now for this one, 500 gram, same 500 gram. But the difference is the molecules are very tightly packed. The molecules are very closely packed. So the density is very high. Now density is very high, mass is same, so obviously the volume will be low. That's why this box is very small. So whenever the mass is same, whenever the density is low, the volume will be high, and whenever the density is high, the volume will be low. So students, next we will learn how to determine the density of a solid. Suppose I have given you a solid. Now how we will find the density of the solid? First we will find its mass. How? By using beam balance. In the lab you have seen beam balance. We put it in the beam balance, and by using weight box we will find out the mass of the object. Next we will find its volume. Now there are two types of solid. One is regular solids and one is irregular solids. Irregular solids means those whose shape is not defined. Regular solid means those whose shape is well defined. For example, cube. In the cube, all the sides are same. Now what is the formula to find the volume of the cube? Side into side into side. Next, cuboid. In cuboid, what is the volume to find the length? Volume of the cuboid? Length into breadth into height. What is the formula to find the volume of the sphere? 4/3 pi r^2. And the volume of cylinder is 1/3 pi r^2 h. These formulas are given for the solids, those who have regular shape. Now, what is the volume? How we will find the volume of irregular shape solid? By water displacement method. What is water displacement method? In the next part only we will understand. Now, first we find out the mass. Then already we have found out the volume. Sometimes by using formula, sometimes by using water displacement method. Then we will put this one, these two values in the formula of density. What is the formula of density? Density is equal to mass by volume. So we will divide this mass by its volume, and we will easily get the value of the density. So students, now we will do a numerical. In this numerical, we will find the density of a stone. Which stone? This stone. As you can see, this stone is irregular shape. So we already have seen that first what we have to find? Its mass. Now the problem is here, mass is already given. How much? 100 gram. Now we have to find the volume of this stone. Now as it is irregular shape solid, we have to use the water displacement method. Now this is a measuring cylinder. At first, how much is the water level? 50 milliliter. So V1 is our 50 milliliter. As soon as we put this object, this stone, inside the water, what will happen? The water level will rise. So V1 will become V2. How much is the V2? 60 milliliter. So how much is the water addition? That is the volume of the stone. So volume of the stone is what? V2 minus V1. That is 60 minus 50. 60 milliliter minus 50 milliliter, milliliter is how much? 10 milliliter. Now 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cube. 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cube. So 10 milliliter is equal to 10 centimeter cube. So mass of this pump already given, that is 100 gram. Mass of this stone is 100 gram. So what will be the density of this stone? Density of this stone is mass by volume. What is our mass? 100 gram. What is our volume? 10 centimeter cube. So mass by volume, 100 by 10 is 10 gram per centimeter cube. Now if in the question it is given, we have to find it in kg per meter cube. This is the CDS unit. Now if the question is to find it SI unit, just we will multiply it by 1000. So it will become 1000 into 10, 10,000 kg per meter. So hope you understood this sum. So students, next we will learn about relative density. Now relative density is a very important topic, so you must learn it very carefully. What is relative density? It is the ratio of the density of a substance to the density of water at 4 degrees. That means we are doing the ratio of the density of the substance to the density of water at 4 degrees. Suppose you have given an object. Now, what will be the relative density of the object? It will be the ratio of the density of that object divided by the density of water at 4 degrees. Now, this 4 degrees is very important because at the 4 degrees temperature, the density of water is maximum. So, this density of water at 4 degrees, this part is very, very important. So we are actually comparing the density of that object with what? With the density of water at 4 degrees. Now from the definition only we find out what will be the formula for relative density. Relative density formula is density of the substance by density of the water at 4 degrees. So density of the substance divided by density of the water at 4 degrees. Now density of the this formula can be used to find relative density. Now another formula to find relative density is mass of the substance divided by mass of the water at 4 degrees. So at that time we don't need its density, what we need its mass, and this one is mass. So simple thing. So again I am telling what is relative density. Relative density is the ratio of the density of a substance to the density of water at 4 degrees. Suppose you are given an object. First what we will find out is density. Then we will divide the density of that object by the density of the water at 4 degrees. Density of the water at 4 degrees is maximum. That's why relative density is compared with the density of water at 4 degrees. Two formulas, one is by using density, another one is by using its mass. So students, now we will learn how to find the relative density of a liquid. Previously we found out the relative density of solid. Now we will find out the relative density of a liquid. How to find the relative density of a liquid? By using a special bottle known as specific gravity bottle. It is also known as picnometer. P-Y-C-N-O-M-E-T-E-R. Picnometer. Now, these are the specific gravity bottles. I have drawn here three. Why you will understand now? Suppose I want to find out a specific gravity of a unbound liquid. I don't know the density of the liquid. Relative density of the liquid. How will we find the relative density of a liquid? Let's see. First we will take the specific gravity bottle, empty specific gravity bottle, and we will find its mass by using beam balance. Let the mass is m1. So m1 is the mass of the empty bottle. Now we will put some water inside that empty bottle and fill it. Again we will measure it by beam balance. Now what will be its mass? The mass of the empty will be mass of the empty bottle plus mass of the water, because inside there is no water. Next m3. What is m3? M3 now. M3 is mass of the empty bottle plus liquid. Which liquid? The liquid that I will put inside, and the liquid whose specific gravity or specific relative density I want to find out. So what is m3? M3 is the mass of the empty bottle plus the mass of the liquid. So what will be the mass of the water? So mass of the water will be m2 minus m1. Mass of the water will be m2 minus m1. And what will be the mass of the liquid? The unknown liquid whose relative density we want to find out, that mass will be m3 minus m1. formula to find relative density of that unknown liquid will be m3 minus m1 by m2 minus m1. Always remember, the mass of the water will be in the denominator and the mass of the unknown liquid will always be in the numerator. Don't ever forget this part. If some student write m2 minus m1 by m3 minus m1, it will be wrong. Always remember, the mass of the water will be in the denominator and the mass of the liquid will be in the numerator. So, students, we will learn how to find the relative density of methanol in this sum. So, we already know the relative density formula of a liquid, that is m3 minus m1 by m2 minus m1. We just learned that. Now, in this sum, the mass of the empty bottle is given. How much? 35. The mass of the bottle plus the mass of the water is also given. That is 75. And the mass of the bottle plus the mass of the methanol is given. How much? 67. So, m1 is given. How much? 35. M2 is given. How much? 75. M3 is given how much? 67. So mass of the water will be how much? M2 minus M1. That means 75 minus 35. How much? 40. Mass of the liquid. Which one liquid? Methanol. Mass of the methanol is how much? M3 minus M1. M3 is our 67. M1 is our 35. So 67 minus 35. That means how much? 32. So relative density of the methanol formula is given. M3 minus M1 by M2 minus M1. What is our M3 minus M1? That is 32. What is our M2 minus M1? That is 40. 32 by 40, 8 by 10, that means 0.8. Relative density does not have any unit because it is a ratio. Ratio does not have any unit. So relative density of the methanol is how much? 0.8. So what will be the density of the methanol? Just multiply relative density by 1 gram per centimeter cube. You will get 0.8 gram per centimeter cube. And 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kg per meter cube. So multiply this one by 1000, we will get 800 kg per meter cube. So again, I am telling this sum is very important and the relative density formula of liquid is very important.